For more on that, I want to bring in Iranian American journalist and commentator Negar Mortazavi. She focuses on U.S. foreign policy in the Middle East. I want to first start in London, where Theresa May is expected to host an emergency response meeting on Monday to discuss the crisis. What are her options there?
Well, it seems like the UK doesn't want to enter a military confrontation with Iran, but at the same time, they want to put pressure on the Iranians to try to convince them to let go of this tanker. At the same time, the Iranians also are trying to have their tanker that was seized by the UK released at the same time. So I think there are very few options, but we still have to remember that the UK and Iran have diplomatic relations. The UK has presence on the ground in Iran and vice versa. So I think there is a good chance of this being resolved diplomatically. And Iran doesn't see the UK as the main target. This is just them trying to leverage or pressure, put more pressure on the US, who's the main party to all of this tension, and stand up with Iran.
So this is a three-way fight, if you will, the US, the UK against Iran. But what do you think is Tehran's next move here? I mean, are they waiting for Washington or London to flinch?
Well, I think the Iranians, they have entered in confrontation and defense mode, but at the same time, it seems like they're doing it very calculated, or they've been careful to take strategic steps, not blow this out of proportion and not let this escalate out of hand. We even saw the seizure of the UK tanker. It was basically replicated in the same method that the UK seized the Iranian tanker 2 weeks ago in the Gibraltar. So I think the Iranians want to still keep themselves in the victim situation, which was the case with President Trump pulling out of the nuclear deal a year ago and Iran staying compliant to the deal for a year and basically waiting for Europe to make up for the economic loss. But in the past few weeks or a couple of months, I would say it's entered a very dangerous and tense situation. And I think all sides should basically start to try to de-escalate this diplomatically.
And this has really put the UK sort of in the middle between the US and Europe. The US pulled out of that nuclear deal, the JCPOA. Europe is still in it. The UK is a part of that. How does that change its dynamics?
Well, the Iranians are, as I said, they don't see you. The EU is not their main target. The main target is the U.S., or basically the main party that they see as violating the nuclear pact is the U.S., the President Trump. But at the same time with the Iranians, the way they see it is that the EU has been politically supporting the deal and saying they're staying in, but Iran is not getting the economic benefit that they expected because of the pressure of U.S. sanctions on European companies and the fact that European governments can't really force these private companies to do business with Iran. But then at the same time, what the Iranians are saying is, if you say you want to stay in the deal and we're not seeing the economic benefits, what kind of deal is that? And the EU, basically them being in the deal or not, doesn't really matter to the Iranians at this point. It's mainly the U.S. who they've decided is the party they need to resolve the issue with.
And Javad Zarif, the Iranian foreign minister, has accused the U.K. of basically doing the U.S.'s bidding there. Are we seeing parallels here from 2003, when Blair sided with Bush over the rest of Europe, the issue of Iraq? Do we see any similarities here?
I think we definitely see some similarities. It's not, the situation is not as tense as back then because A, the American people doesn't want a war in the Middle East, and President Trump himself doesn't want a war with Iran. He's an isolationist. He campaigned against the war. So he's been careful to not let this get out of hand. But at the same time, it's such a volatile and small region that it's not a laboratory that you can keep everything 100% under control. So both sides have been trying to not let this escalate and get out of hand. But I don't think that's going to be the situation for a very long time unless they start to de-escalate and resolve this basically diplomatically. So this could also be a prelude to Iran and the U.S. getting ready to get back to the negotiating table and resolving this.
A lot of moving parts to watch here. Negar Mortazavi, thank you for your insights.
Thank you.